कैसेट क्लिनिक्स द आइडियल केस प्रेजेंटेशंस बाय डॉक्टर घनश्याम वैद्य. यू आर लिसनिंग टू द केस प्रेजेंटेशंस इन मेडिसिन रेस्पिरेटरी सिस्टम अ केस ऑफ प्लूरल इफ्यूजन.
अ 25 ईयर ओल्ड मेल हिंदू पेशेंट प्रवीण स्टेइंग एट गोकाक फार्मर बाय ऑक्यूपेशन कम्स विद कंप्लेंट्स ऑफ पेन इन द राइट लोअर चेस्ट एंड फीवर सिंस 10 डेज एंड कफ एंड ब्रेथलेसनेस सिंस 5 डेज. The pain started 10 days back over the right lower chest, increasing on deep inspiration.
What type of pain is this?
This is a typical pleural pain, increasing on deep inspiration or coughing. Pain due to fractured ribs and severe costochondritis can also increase on deep breathing.
Proceed.
The pain subsided over the next 4 days and is now replaced by a dull ache and heaviness.
What does this suggest?
This history is very suggestive of pleurisy. In the initial stage of dry pleurisy, the inflamed layers of pleura rub against each other on breathing, producing sharp pain. But when the fluid collects, the layers of pleura are separated and the sharp pain is replaced by a dull ache.
Proceed.
He also had low-grade fever without chills since 10 days. There is history of dry cough since 5 days, no history of expectoration or hemoptysis.
What does a dry cough suggest?
Dry cough is seen in upper respiratory tract infections, allergic coughs, bronchial asthma, pleural irritation, early tuberculosis and early left ventricular failure.
And when is cough associated with expectoration?
Expectoration, that is productive cough, indicates active infection and inflammation of the lung parenchyma or the tracheobronchial tree. For example, pneumonia, tuberculosis, chronic bronchitis or bronchiectasis.
Proceed.
The patient has breathlessness on routine activities, that is grade 3 dyspnea. There is no history of wheezing, no history of paroxysmal nocturnal dyspnea. There is history of increased dyspnea on lying on left side.
What is dyspnea?
Dyspnea is defined as an uncomfortable awareness of breathing. It is characterized by increased respiratory effort associated with distress or discomfort.
How do you grade dyspnea?
Exertional dyspnea is graded as grade 1 if it appears only on unaccustomed physical activity, grade 2 if it appears on accustomed physical activity, grade 3 if it appears on routine activities, and grade 4 if it is present at rest.
What do you mean by accustomed physical activity?
That is an exertion for which the patient did not become dyspneic when he was in health. For example, for a postman, his routine walk is his accustomed physical activity. For a sportsman, the daily sports activity is the accustomed physical activity.
Which respiratory diseases cause exertional dyspnea?
All conditions reducing the vital capacity of the lungs produce exertional dyspnea. For example, emphysema, fibrosis, collapse, pleural effusion or pneumothorax.
Proceed.
Regarding etiology, there is history of fever, cough and breathlessness suggesting an infective origin. There is history of close contact with tuberculosis in the house. There is no history of wheezing, attacks of sneezing or rhinitis. There is no history of palpitations, leg edema or paroxysmal nocturnal dyspnea. No history of dysphagia or hoarseness of voice or stridor.
Why?
For mediastinal mass and laryngeal growth.
Right. In etiology, try to find out whether the symptoms are due to infection, allergy, mediastinal pathology or secondary to cardiac disease. Proceed.
There is no history of diabetes or any other major illness in the past. No family history of asthma or any allergic diseases. Personal history, chews tobacco but non-smoker, no addiction to alcohol, sleep, bowel and micturition habits are normal. On examination,
wait, on analyzing the history findings, what conclusions can you draw?
Firstly, this is primarily a respiratory affection as there are no cardiac symptoms. Secondly, this is a pleural pathology as the pain is pleural type. There is no expectoration, no wheezing to suggest affection of the lung parenchyma or airway. Thirdly, this is an infective condition as it is associated with fever and is acute in origin. Considering all factors, plus a pleural pain which is now replaced by a dull ache, history is very suggestive of a right-sided pleural effusion.
Very good. At the end of the history, you should analyze and decide, number 1, whether it is a primary affection of the respiratory system or is secondary to a cardiovascular disease. Number 2, whether it is affecting the pleura, lung parenchyma or the airway. Number 3, whether it is an infective condition or a non-infective condition. Number 4, whether it is an acute or chronic affection. And lastly, what does the overall symptomatology suggest? Proceed.
On general examination, the patient is averagely built and nourished. Nails show no pallor, no cyanosis or clubbing. Sclera shows no icterus. Conjunctiva and mucous membranes show pallor, no cyanosis.
What type of cyanosis do you see in respiratory diseases?
Central cyanosis, due to reduced oxygen in the arterial blood due to inadequate oxygenation in the lungs. Peripheral cyanosis may coexist in advanced lesions with cor pulmonale and CCF.
How do you clinically differentiate central from peripheral cyanosis?
Central cyanosis is seen in conjunctiva, tongue and mucous membrane of the mouth, while peripheral cyanosis is seen in the skin of the extremities, nails, cheeks, earlobes and lips. Secondly, extremities are cold in peripheral cyanosis while warm in central cyanosis. Pulse is 84 per minute, regular, good volume and normal character. Respiratory rate is 28 per minute, regular, thoracoabdominal. Respiration pulse ratio is increased to 1:3.
When is the respiration pulse ratio increased?
In pulmonary diseases with increased respiratory rate, for example pneumonia, pleural effusion, pneumothorax or collapse.
And when is it decreased?
In narcotic poisoning with respiratory depression. Also in tachycardia due to cardiac disease or thyrotoxicosis, it is decreased.
Proceed.
The blood pressure is 120 by 80 millimeters of mercury. Jugular venous pressure is not raised. No edema over the legs.
When is jugular venous pressure raised due to lung disease?
In cor pulmonale, that is CCF secondary to chronic obstructive lung disease. And when intrathoracic pressure is raised, as in massive pleural effusion or tension pneumothorax. There is no significant lymphadenopathy. There are no stigmata of tuberculosis, no evidence of Horner syndrome.
Which are the stigmata of tuberculosis?
Scars and sinuses in the neck, flictenular conjunctivitis, thickened spermatic cord, erythema nodosum and cutis vulgaris.
Proceed.
On examination of the upper respiratory tract, throat and tonsils are normal, no congestion, nasal cavity is normal, no sinus tenderness, no movement of the LA nasi. On inspection, the shape of the chest is normal, elliptical and symmetrical, and the subcostal angle is about 70 degrees. There is bulging of the intercostal spaces on the right side, no localized flattening or retraction, spine is normal, no kyphoscoliosis.
What does the bulging of the intercostal spaces suggest?
Bulging of the intercostal spaces is usually due to pleural effusion or empyema or pneumothorax.
And where do you see bulging of the chest wall?
Localized bulging is seen in the precordium due to cardiomegaly or elsewhere due to cold abscess from the ribs, empyema necessitans, surgical emphysema and on the right side amoebic liver abscess.
Why did you examine the spine for kyphoscoliosis?
Because kyphoscoliosis causes secondary asymmetry of the chest wall, which may be mistaken for localized bulge or retraction of the chest wall. Also, it may alter the position of the mediastinum.
Proceed.
The respiratory rate is 28 per minute, regular, mainly abdominal. Inspiratory and expiratory phases are equal. Accessory muscles of respiration are not acting.
Is the respiration normal?
No, sir. There is tachypnea or increased respiratory rate of 28 per minute. Normal respiratory rate is 16 to 20 per minute. Secondly, the breathing is mainly abdominal, suggesting lung disease.
How is it normally?
In males, it is abdominothoracic and in females, it is thoracoabdominal. That is, in males, the diaphragm and the abdominal wall muscles are dominant, while in females, the intercostal muscles are dominant.
Where do you see thoracic breathing?
In peritonitis, due to pain on abdominal movements. Then in severe ascites and in diaphragm paralysis. Abdominal breathing is seen in painful chest. For example, rib fractures or a dry pleurisy. Then in lung collapse and intercostal muscle paralysis.
What is Chine-Stokes breathing?
It is characterized by paroxysms of shallow breathing, progressing to slow, deep breathing, followed by apnea. It is seen in narcotic poisoning and intracranial diseases.
Proceed.
There is diminished movement of right lower side of the chest, that is intercostal retraction is reduced and outward movement of the right costal margin is reduced.
How did you inspect the movement of the chest wall?
With the patient sitting on a stool, I inspected the anterior and the posterior wall standing in front of and behind the patient. Then, with the patient lying supine, I observed the chest tangentially from the foot end, each time asking the patient to take deep breaths.
What did you look for?
First, I compared the amplitude of movement on each side in symmetrical areas. It is reduced in the right infraaxillary area. Then, I noted the nature of the movement. It is expansile, not up and down like in emphysema. Then I noticed the inspiratory retraction of the intercostal spaces, which is reduced in the right lower chest. Then I observed the outward movement of the costal margin, which also is reduced on the right side. Lastly, I looked for accessory muscles of respiration which are not active.
What is the analysis of your inspection findings till now?
The right lower chest shows diminished movements, so I would consider a right pleural effusion or empyema, pneumothorax, lower lobe pneumonia, collapse or fibrosis. There is associated bulging of the intercostal spaces. So, a pleural effusion or empyema and a tension pneumothorax is more likely.
Proceed.
The apex impulse is seen in the left fifth intercostal space 2 cm lateral to the mid-clavicular line. Trail sign is negative.
Significance?
The lower mediastinum is pushed to the left side.
Is it pushed to the left side or pulled to the left side?
Sir, the less moving area is always the side of the pathology. Here it is on the right side, so it has pushed the mediastinum towards the opposite side.
Where is the apex impulse normally situated?
In the left fifth intercostal space, just inside the midclavicular line. Shift of apex impulse in absence of heart disease indicates a shift of the lower mediastinum. And a shift of the trachea indicates shift of the upper mediastinum.
Proceed.
The chest wall shows no scarce sinuses or dilated veins, no visible pulsations, no shininess of the skin over the right lower chest.
When do you see shininess of the skin?
In empyema, amoebic liver abscess and chest wall infections.
Good. So on inspection, you have first seen the shape and symmetry of the chest, then you observed the respiratory movements, then the position of the mediastinum, and lastly, looked for any other visible sign on the chest wall. What is your conclusion?
Intercostal bulging and diminished movement of the right lower chest with shift of mediastinum to the opposite side is suggestive of a right pleural effusion, empyema or pneumothorax. On palpation, the findings of the inspection are confirmed. The chest movements are reduced on the right lower chest.
How did you palpate for the chest movements?
With the patient sitting on a stool, I gripped the chest with both hands with thumbs meeting in the midline and compared the extent of the outward movement of the thumbs during inspiration. I palpated in this manner in the upper, middle and lower zones anteriorly and then over the back. I found that the movements are reduced in the right lower zone.
How did you palpate for the apical movements?
By standing behind the patient, I kept both hands over the clavicles with the thumbs meeting in the midline posteriorly. I observed for the separation of the thumbs during inspiration and also the upward movement of the hands over the clavicles.
How will you detect diaphragm paralysis on palpation?
With the patient lying in supine position, I kept one hand over the sternum and one over the epigastrium. During inspiration, both the hands rise, indicating that the diaphragm is not paralyzed. If the diaphragm was paralyzed, the hand on the epigastrium would show paradoxical retraction during inspiration.
Proceed.
The trachea is central. The apex beat is in the fifth intercostal space, 2 cm lateral to the midclavicular line. That is, it is displaced to the left. Tactile vocal fremitus is absent over the right lower intercostal spaces, below the fourth intercostal space in mid-axillary line.
What is tactile vocal fremitus?
Tactile vocal fremitus is the perception of vibrations produced in the larynx during phonation by a hand kept over the chest wall.
Why is it absent here over the right lower chest?
Because the vibrations are not conducted to the chest wall. The cause may be a pleural effusion, एम्पाइमा, न्यूमोथोरैक्स, फाइब्रोसिस और कोलैप्स।
हाउ डिड यू टेस्ट इट?
आई आस्क द पेशेंट टू से 111 रिपीटेडली विद कॉन्स्टेंट इंटेंसिटी ऑफ वॉइस। देन आई पाल्पेटेड विद द अल्नर बॉर्डर ऑफ माई राइट हैंड एंड कंपेयर्ड ओवर सिमेट्रिकल एरियाज ऑन बोथ साइड्स ऑफ द चेस्ट फ्रॉम एपेक्स टू बेस इन ईच इंटरकोस्टल स्पेस, फर्स्ट एंटीरियरली, देन अलोंग द एक्सिला एंड देन पोस्टीरियरली।
Why did you palpate with the ulnar border of the hand?
To bring a closer contact of the hand bones with the chest wall.
Why did you ask the patient to say 111?
Resonant vowels like N, M produce the most satisfactory fremitus. So any short phrase in the patient's language containing these vowels will do. For example, 1, 2, 3,
proceed.
No other palpable vibrations. No intercostal tenderness over the right lower intercostal spaces?
Yes, that is a very important observation.
Yes, sir. It rules out empyema. Intercostal tenderness is seen in pleural inflammation. For example, dry pleurisy, empyema, sometimes with pneumonia. And on the right side, it may be seen with amoebic liver abscess. On percussion, the superficial cardiac dullness extends 2 cm lateral to the left midclavicular line in the 5th intercostal space. Percussing the lung, Chronic's isthmus is normal on both the sides. There is a stony dull note over the right inframammary, infraaxillary and infrascapular regions. The upper border of this dullness is in the 3rd intercostal space in midclavicular line, 4th intercostal space in midaxillary line, and 7th intercostal space in the scapular line. No shifting dullness, liver dullness is continuous with it.
What does this suggest?
A stony dull note rising up in the axilla without a shifting dullness is characteristic of a pleural effusion.
Why is it stony dull?
Because the underlying fluid damps all vibrations of the chest wall and the collapsed lung.
When is it impaired?
In consolidation, infiltration, fibrosis and collapse, where the amount of air in the alveoli is reduced. Also, it is impaired when the pleura is thickened.
When do you get a hyper-resonant percussion note?
In emphysema, pneumothorax, large cavity, lung cyst and eventration of diaphragm.
And how did you test for the shifting dullness?
With the patient sitting on the bed, I percussed in the right axillary area from above downwards till I reached the dullness. Then I made the patient lie on the left side and percussed at the same point after 10 seconds. The area remained dull. It did not become hyper-resonant, so there is no shifting dullness.
In which conditions do you get shifting dullness?
In hydropneumothorax or pyopneumothorax.
Proceed.
There is a boxy note of scodaic resonance one space above the dullness.
What is scodaic resonance?
It is a hyper-resonant note with a boxy quality heard over the relaxed lung just above the level of a pleural effusion. Trops area is normal. Grocco's triangle of dullness is on the left side.
What is trops area?
Trops area is an area of tympanic note above the left costal margin, bounded by lung resonance above, liver dullness on the right, and splenic dullness on the left. If it is dull, it suggests a left pleural effusion.
And what is Grocco's triangle of dullness?
It is a triangular area of impaired note over the back of the chest on opposite, that is normal side in case of a pleural effusion. It extends between a horizontal line at the 10th thoracic spine and the top level of the effusion in midline. It occurs due to a shift of the posterior mediastinum and compression of the opposite lung at its wedge-shaped base.
Proceed.
On auscultation, the breath sounds are absent over the area of the right lung marked by dullness on percussion. The breath sounds over the rest of the lung are normal, vesicular, with no Rales, ronchi or rub.
What are the characteristics of normal vesicular breath sounds?
They have a rustling character. Inspiration is longer and louder than the expiration, and there is no pause between inspiration and expiration.
What are the different types of breath sounds that you know of?
Vesicular, bronchovesicular and bronchial. The bronchial breath sounds may be tubular or high-pitched, cavernous or low-pitched, and emphoric, that is low-pitched with high-pitched echo-like overtones.
What are the characteristics of bronchial breath sounds?
They have a hollow character, no rustling. Expiration is equal to or longer than inspiration, and there is a pause between inspiration and expiration.
When are the breath sounds absent?
In pleural effusion, empyema, pneumothorax, bronchial obstruction and collapse.
What is a pleural rub?
It is a harsh grating sound heard during inspiration as well as expiration due to rubbing of the inflamed layers of pleura against each other.
How does it differ from the RALS?
Pleural rub is a very harsh creaking sound compared to RALS, which are fine crackling sounds. Pleural rub is a superficial sound and it increases on pressing the stethoscope, whereas RALS don't. After coughing, the RALS may alter, but rub is constant. And lastly, the pleural rub is associated with local pain and tenderness.
Did you expect a pleural rub in this patient?
No, sir. As he has pleural effusion with fluid separating the layers of the pleura, pleural rub will not be produced. In early stage of dry pleurisy, he might have had the pleural rub.
Proceed.
Vocal resonance is diminished in this area and at the upper border, egophony is heard. Whispering pectoriloquy is not heard.
What is egophony?
It is a type of increased vocal resonance where a nasal quality is imparted to the sound, seen just above the level of a pleural effusion.
When is the vocal resonance diminished?
In pleural effusion, pneumothorax, thickened pleura and emphysema.
And when is it increased?
Over a consolidation and a superficial cavity. When it is increased, the spoken voice is heard loud and clear, as if the voice is produced near the ear, though the words are not distinguishable. This is termed as bronchophony.
How did you test for the vocal resonance?
With the patient in sitting position, I asked the patient to say 1-1-1 repeatedly with constant intensity of voice. I auscultated over symmetrical areas on both sides of the chest, from apex to the base, first anteriorly, then along the axilla, and then posteriorly. On examination of the other systems, the heart sounds are normal, liver and spleen are not palpable, no free fluid in the abdomen.
Why did you look for free fluid in the abdomen?
A right pleural effusion with ascites may suggest Meek syndrome associated with simple ovarian tumors. It may also be seen in transudative conditions like congestive cardiac failure, hypoproteinemia and chronic renal failure.
Go ahead.
My diagnosis is right pleural effusion, most probably due to tuberculosis.
Why do you say that this is a pleural effusion?
There is history of pleural pain replaced by a dull ache with fever, cough and breathlessness. On examination, there is diminished movement of the right lower chest with bulging intercostal spaces. There is stony dull percussion note, the upper border of which rises in the axilla, with decreased tactile vocal fremitus, absent breath sounds and decreased vocal resonance. There is chordaic resonance and egophony just above the upper border of this dullness. The apex beat is pushed to the opposite side. All these findings are suggestive of a right pleural effusion.
But why not empyema?
Sir, there is no history of high fever. There is no intercostal tenderness or shininess of the overlying skin. So this is not likely to be empyema, though in an empyema, the other signs will be very similar.
Why not consolidation?
Sir, bulging of intercostal spaces, shift of apex beat to the opposite side and stony dull percussion note are not seen with consolidation. Also, in the affected area, there are no bronchial breath sounds and vocal resonance is absent. In consolidation, I would expect tubular type of bronchial breath sounds and increased vocal resonance with bronchophony.